There is still a medal at stake, you would say. Here's Filipowski of Poland, sixth after the short program. But there are two Soviets who were fourth and fifth, one of whom, or it could be Filipowski, could move ahead of Fedeya for the bronze.
Interestingly, Jim, I think that the reason that Boitano won with the closeness of those marks was that they tied over many of the judges, but Boitano won the technical mark, and the technical mark is one of the tie breakers.
Right. Well, we say the competition is not over. Gregorz Filipowski of Poland is on the ice, fifth in the 1987 World Championships in Cincinnati last year. He's the young man who was coming to the United States to train, thought he was going to Rochester, New York, got the wrong plane, ended up in Rochester, Minnesota, and darn if he didn't stay there, and he's been there ever since training. Has won its first gold and first silver medals of these games. They now have one of each medal, gold, silver, and bronze. If you want with us, the silver was won by Eric Plain in speed skating.
You see the way he's kind of, said, well, I guess that's it, folks. I guess it's impossible for anyone to come out and skate after those two performances, yeah. which were so brilliant. And Filipowski, it just doesn't have the elegance or the overall look to it.
Seemed to be what he was saying. Okay, more skating to come after this message and a word from your local station. The USA, Denmark, the Soviet Union, Switzerland, and Japan. Brian Orser got the first place votes of four judges. In other words, only a one majority there. He got the two Germanys, both West and East, Canada, and Czechoslovakia. Now, Scotty Hamill's been watching all this in Lake Tahoe. Do you think he had it, Scotty, or what?
I'm watching this thing, and I'm going, that, without a doubt, had to be probably the finest technical program I've ever seen in my life. That was amazing, and for Brian Orser to have to skate after that, it's like you guys say, the thrill of victory and the agony of defeat. It was the most exciting men's competition I've ever seen.
But you would have called it that way?
I definitely would have called it that way. As much as I feel for Brian, he was second in 84 and second again here. It's, you know, he made a couple minor mistakes, and Boitano was just perfect. You couldn't pick anything out of Boitano's program tonight that wasn't perfect.
Well, I asked you what you'd say to Brian Boitano before he went out to skate. What would you have to say to him now as the guy who won it 4 years ago and now the USA has won it again?
The greatest feeling in the world is the 10 minutes after you win a championship like this. And I couldn't be happier for him. He's the hardest working competitor I've ever seen in my life. And he's a good friend, and I really, I don't even know what to say. He's just, I'm really happy for him.
Okay, Scott, thanks very, very much. Enjoy your evening in Lake Tahoe with Ty and Randy and all the gang. So let's go back to the competition now. I'm in the anchor position, as I have been all